So let's take a look at the menu bar. The menu bar is this strip that you see at the very top of your screen. We're just going to look at the left side of it, which contain the menus. On the right side, over here, are menu bar icons, and we'll deal with them in another tutorial. On the left side, you always see the Apple menu, and this stays here no matter what's going on your Mac. And this is how you access functions like restart, shutdown, and other things. The second item changes depending upon what app you're using. Matter of fact, the name of that item is the app that you're currently using. In this case, we're using the Finder, which is how we view files and folders. If I were to switch to, say, Pages, you can see this menu changes to Pages. If I would switch to, say, Mail, it changes to Mail. Safari, it changes to Safari. So we get a menu specific to that app. Now, with a few exceptions, you'll find here the ability to quit the current app at the bottom of the menu with the app's name. Then you'll find a bunch of other menus, and what they contain depends upon what app you're using. But there is kind of a general sequence. Usually you find the File and Edit menus as the very next thing. And File allows you to do things like open documents, save documents, close documents, things like that. You also find print commands at the bottom there. Edit usually has things like copy, cut, paste, spelling and grammar, and things like that. Then it really changes depending upon the app. So here in Pages we have insert, format, arrange, which are things you would do in a word processor. If we switch to, say, Safari, then you can see view, history, bookmarks. These are things that you would do in a web browser. So to select anything in one of these menus, what you basically would do is you would click on the menu bar name here, and you can click and hold down on your trackpad or mouse, move down to the item you want, and release. Or you can click once, the menu will come down and stay there, and you could have released your hold on the mouse or trackpad. You can go to what you want and then click again on the item that you want to choose. So there are two different ways to choose which command you want to execute. You also notice that most commands here in the menus have these symbols over here to the right. These symbols tell you what the keyboard shortcut is for this command. So if you don't want to go all the way up to the menu but you want to keep your hands on the keyboard, you can use these keyboard shortcuts to do the same thing. So you look for the special symbol. This symbol right here represents the command key on your keyboard, and you can see that same symbol on the command key. That up arrow is the shift key. This symbol right here is the option key. And you also see a symbol like this, a caret it's called, and that represents the control key. So you see different combinations of these. For instance, to use the home command you do shift, command, and then the H key on the keyboard. So if you find yourself using a command pretty often, you can look in the menu for these shortcuts and try to learn them so you don't have to always go to the menu to use that command. Now, one menu item you'll almost always find in every app is Help. And Help, of course, as you can imagine, allows you to get to documentation for the app that you're currently using. But there's also a search command, and you can use this to search not just in the documentation but for a command in another menu that may be hard to find. So if you know you want to do something like export bookmarks, you can start typing the word book and you can see all the different menu commands that have those characters in it. And as you move your cursor over them, it actually shows you where they're located. So you can select it from here, but you can also learn where it is by looking elsewhere. So I can see that that's in the File menu. So for next time I don't have to search for it. I know where to go. Now you'll notice that as you look through menus, you see some of the items are grayed out or inactive. You can't select them. Like Cut, Copy, and Paste cannot be selected right now. This is because these commands don't have the ability to work with the way things are. For instance, I don't have any text selected, so there's nothing to cut or copy. However, if I were to go over to the web page here and select some text, then go to Edit, you can see now Copy is available. I can't cut because this is a web page. I can't change what's on the page, but I can copy text from it, so that becomes active. So if you see something that's grayed out, that means it's just not available to be used right now in the context. Maybe you need to select something, maybe you need to go to a different screen, or you need to be using the app in a different way. So the last thing I want to show you is that the commands listed can change if you hold down modifier keys on your keyboard. Those are the Shift, Control, Option, or Command keys. So for instance, if you look in the View menu, you can see here Zoom In and Zoom Out are items here. But if I were to hold down the Option key, you could see they change to make text bigger, make text smaller. They're related commands, but they're different. You can see the keyboard shortcut changes here to show that I'm holding the Option key down. So sometimes if you're looking through a menu, hold down the Option key or the Command key or the Shift key to see what you can get. So in History here, Clear History becomes Clear History and Keep Website Data if I hold down the Option key.